In the context of a book, front matter and back matter refers to the information presented before and after the main content of the book, respectively. Front matter sets the stage for your book, and in addition to key publication information, it can also include elements such as a preface, acknowledgments page, or introduction that give context to the book, or acknowledge those who helped bring the book to fruition. In short, the front matter prepares the reader for what's to come and offers a formal introduction to the book. The back matter, on the other hand, offers additional information that complements or supplements the main content of the book. This might include endnotes or footnotes, an index for easy navigation, a glossary for understanding key terms, or an author biography for readers who want to learn more about the author. In Atticus, you'll find the front matter section is separated from the body by a line in the left navigation panel. This is primarily because industry standards require standard pagination to begin on the first page of the body section. To do so, the body must be separated from the front matter. Any pages in your book that appear before the table of contents, such as your title page or your copyright page, will not have a page number at all. Any page that appears after the table of contents but remains in the front matter section before the body content, that will be numbered with Roman numerals. The back matter pages will just continue with the standard pagination and don't need to be separated from the body content. When you import a manuscript from a DocX file, all your content will automatically be added to the body section, including any pages that you want to be in the front matter. Moving them into place is as easy as just clicking on the page title from the left navigation pane and dragging it to where you want it to be located and just dropping it there. Atticus automatically includes certain pages with each book, a title page, a copyright page, and a table of contents. The title page is created based on the details you input for your book. While this is fully functional, it may or may not reflect the style you want for your book. If you prefer, you can design a title page to match the cover or other aesthetics of your book instead. Be sure to size the image to match the trim settings of your print book before importing it into Atticus. From the title page, you can click the link at the top that says Convert to Full Page Image. And from here, you can upload your title page image and choose either to extend to the margins of your book or go full bleed. Next, let's look at the copyright page. This is automatically generated by Atticus with every new or imported book. You can simply adjust a few details for your book, or you can paste your own copyright information into this page to maintain the industry standard formatting. The template that is automatically generated is a simple copyright. If you click the three dots beside the Add Chapter button at the bottom of the left navigation pane, you'll see that Atticus also offers advanced copyright template options, including general fiction, general nonfiction, and public domain copyright. The table of contents is not directly editable, though you can choose certain aspects to include or not include based on the content of your book. If you're working on a single volume book, you'll have the option to show or hide the subtitles and subheadings. If you are creating a box set or a book with multiple parts or volumes, you'll see additional options appear as you add sections to your book. You'll need to check the boxes in order to see additional options as applicable. If you have any specific pages or chapters that you would like to hide in the TOC, click on that specific page. And if you look to the right of that title, you'll see a gear icon. At the bottom of the list that opens, you'll find the option to hide in table of contents. Using these chapter menu options, you can adjust any regular chapter. But Atticus also has a variety of preset layouts that will help you match general industry standards for different page types. If you click the three dots beside the Add Chapter button, you'll find a menu listing for preset layouts with your options. For a closer look at each page type, check out our Front and Back Matter Preset Page Layouts tutorial for more details. For now, how would you like to see more examples from real Atticus authors like yourself? Let's check out some books. you.